Assalamu alaikum. Well, to get started, first we'll create a new Flutter project. Then after that, we'll come to our pubspec.yml file and install three plugins. So we have Firebase Core, Firebase Auth, and Google Sign In. With these three plugins, we'll be able to successfully sign in with Google account. And then you need to run pubget. And for iOS itself, click on this pod file and then open in Xcode. And right after that, click on this runner. And over here, we'll select 10. Then we'll go back to our project and then we'll do pubget again. Now we'll go to Firebase console, Firebase official website, and create a project from there. So here we'll create a new project. First, we'll create a new app. First, we'll create for iOS and then for Android. Now, over here, we need to put app bundle. App bundle would be coming from your Xcode. Well, just now you opened it and copy this section, bundle identifier, and put it right here, and then we'll register. After that, we'll download this one. So we'll open this, show in Finder. Then we'll drag it to our Xcode. So right below this runner, and make sure they're all checked like this. Then we'll have the file over here. After that, we'll continue. Next. Next. We'll select Swift. And from here, we need to copy these two sections, Firebase Core. We'll open our project. And then we'll create another app. We'll click over here. This time we'll create for Android. Then we'll register our app. We need to download it again. Show in Finder. And we need to drag and drop this one right inside this app folder. So here we are seeing this one. Now we need to put this few lines inside this project build.grade file. Now in general, these two are already there. So we'll just copy this one, come to our project, and we'll open this one, build.gradle. Next, app level build.gradle. We'll copy this one and we'll find this file build.gradle over here. And first one is this one, but since it's already there, we don't need this, we'll remove that. And then we'll click next, continue to console. So we need to do a few more setup with this. So we'll come over here, project settings. Now we're here, we need to assign an admin email for this project. So here you should choose any kind of Gmail address or account. That's what it would do. And here, public facing name, we can change this. Using this line, we'll give our app internet permission. Make sure that you write it correctly. Then we'll come over here. And inside this, we'll create a new file and we'll call it auth service. So here we'll have three methods: handle auth state, sign in with Google, and sign out. Actually, these three methods would be called from our UI. And these three methods are core of our app and they're pretty simple. So first we'll go ahead and create handle auth state method. So here is our handle auth state method, and make sure at the top you import Firebase Auth, Firebase Auth dot dart. And inside this method, we have a stream builder. All we do, we are returning a stream builder. Now, stream builder eventually would return a widget. Okay, so what kind of widget we are returning? That is based on the authentication from Firebase. So as you see that, first we get a Firebase instance, and then we get auth state change this method. Now, it would help us to know whether the user has logged in or logged out. Okay, if the user has already logged in, which means that user has authenticated data from the Google server, then we'll go to home page. Of course, we'll create this one very soon. If the user has not logged in, we'll ask the user to go to login page. Okay, after that, we'll create a method that is called sign in with Google. So this is our sign in with Google method, and this method would be called from a button press on the UI. As we click on the button, it will try to get the email ID or Gmail account from your device using this method. If it can find, it will send it to the Google server and wait for authentication. If we get the authentication, based on that authentication over here, we'll create a credential, user credential. That would be our access token and ID token, okay? So that will have a credential which will pass over here to the Firebase. So first we need to connect with our Google account, and then if we get credential, we send this account or information to the Firebase, and Firebase will return us an instance based on this credential, which we'll be using later to show our information like your Gmail account and your name from the Google server. So this is the last method, which is sign in method. So as we see, there is a similarity. Once you have Firebase instance, you can sign in, you can sign out. So now we see at the top we have this home page and a login page. So first we'll go ahead and create a login page. So here we'll create a new Dart class called login page. Now this is a simple stateful class, and which for this you will have the code in the link below. So go ahead and get the code. This is basic UI over here, but most importantly, we have this gesture detector, and from here we call sign in with Google. This is what I have mentioned earlier. Okay, so all it does on the button click, it calls this method. Now right after this, if we come over here, we need to import the login page, and the error should be gone. Now we'll go ahead and create this homepage class. So this is our homepage class, and this is once again simple stateful class. Make sure at the top you import Firebase auth.dart file. And if we are logged in, definitely we would be able to use the current user and display its name, that is username. And at the same time, if we are logged in, we would be able to use current user and its email, okay? Now, if we come to our auth service, we'll see over here, if we imported, the error is gone. Okay, now it's time to combine this all three together from our main.dart file. So here is our main method, and at the top we make sure that we initialize Firebase, and until that we have to wait. And then we call our auth service, and from here we call the method handle auth state, which is over here. Now it would determine whether the user is logged in or not. If the user is logged in, we'll go to the home page and show the user information. If the user is not logged in, we'll ask the user to log in. We'll go ahead and run our app. Now our app has booted, and after that, make sure inside this project you have assets folder, and inside assets folder you have an image google.png. It could be any image, it doesn't matter. And then at the same time, in pop spec.yml file, you have a reference for this image. and make sure the format is correct. Now, if you try to click on this button, we'll see it'll try to get Gmail account from our device. But now it crashed. Now here it's saying that we are missing this in our URL scheme. Now this mostly happens for iOS. So for iOS device, we'll come over here and inside this runner file over here, we'll open up info.plist file. And then we'll put this information inside. So this is the information that's needed for iOS. And over here, inside this string, we'll copy whatever we see from here that's been printed. Now we'll run our app one more time. We see that our app has booted. Now we'll click on this button and it'll ask for the permission. So this is what we see. I'll click on my Gmail account. Here it says that sign. So here we see an error. Error is for authentication. Now this happens because we didn't enable email logging from our Firebase dashboard. So here we'll choose sign in method. So we'll click on Google because we are using Google account to sign in. We'll enable it and save it. And we'll click over here, done. So this time we'll run our app one more time and it restarted. We'll click on this button. So I'll click on my Gmail account. It already talked with the server. And here we see, this is my Gmail name and this is my Gmail account. You can log out. Okay, we are done. You can log in. So it'll ask you the permission again. So we'll click on this. So we log in. Now it's getting the data from the server. So it takes a bit of time. So we are waiting. Now here is our data. So that's how it works. So if you liked and learned something, don't forget to subscribe and smash that like button. Thank you.